Hello and welcome to another video here at cloudwords.net. My name is Mauricio and today I'll teach you how to unblock websites at school or work or wherever you are, really. It's all very simple and all you need is a VPN. Now, there is a right and a wrong way to do this and I'll talk about both in a minute, but first I want to remind you to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon if you want to see more helpful content like this. Now, without further ado, let's just jump right in, shall we? So before I talk about exactly how to unblock a website, first you need to know how a website gets blocked by your school or workplace or even your government or ISP. To communicate with a website, your computer sends out a so-called DNS request to a website. Your network manager and your ISP can see these DNS requests plainly and they know what website you're trying to access. If they see you're trying to open a restricted website, they stop you by blocking communication to the website. But what if they can't see what websites you're accessing? And that's where VPNs come in. A VPN, or virtual private network, encrypts your traffic and all your DNS requests, making it seem like gibberish to others. This makes it impossible for anyone to block your traffic to restricted websites because they simply won't know that you're accessing them. Your signal then gets sent to a VPN server where it gets decrypted and your traffic then goes to the website you want to access. Before it gets back to you, your traffic gets encrypted by the VPN server and it's only decrypted when it reaches your device. This ensures that no one is ever able to see what websites you're visiting. This also works for stuff like online games, which might be blocked in your school. Just connect to your VPN and you'll be able to unblock anything you want. In case you don't know how to use a VPN, here's a quick and easy guide for you. I'll use ExpressVPN in this example, but the steps should apply to basically all other VPNs as well. To unblock a website, first, you need to download and install a VPN. That's pretty easy to do. Just go to the VPN's websites and download the software. If you're on mobile, you can go to the App Store or Play Store and download the app directly from there. Also, you'll need to make an account. Unfortunately, you have to pay for most VPNs, but lucky for you, they almost always offer a money back guarantee. Basically, you get a 30-day refund period and you can ask for your money back at any time during that period. No questions asked. We've tested this, it works. This basically makes the VPN free for up to a month. There are also free VPNs, and although I wouldn't recommend most of them, there are a few good free VPNs out there and I'll mention them in this video guide. So now that you have your VPN installed and you've created your account, it's time to fire up the VPN. You want to open the VPN app and look for a connect button. It'll usually be a big like power button. And by clicking that button, you'll connect to an automatically chosen server that is closest to you. That's really all you need to do to unblock most websites. But what about websites that are blocked in your country? Stick around for the next part. If a website is only available in a certain country, you can unblock it by connecting to a VPN server that's located in that country. This will make the websites think that you're accessing it from within that country, since that's where your decrypted signal is coming from. To change your country, look for a server list in the VPN app. It'll usually be front and center. In ExpressVPN, it's like right below the connect button and click on that server list. Next, find the country you want to spoof. You can either scroll through the server list or simply use the search bar if it's available. Let's go to the United States. Sometimes you can even choose specific cities to connect to, and for this example, I'll go with New York. Now, all you need to do is hit the connect button again, and you're basically done. By the way, this also lets you watch blocked content on websites like Netflix, and for example, if you connect to a US server with a VPN, you can watch US exclusive shows and movies that you cannot get anywhere else. If you need a recommendation for a VPN, the best one to use is ExpressVPN. It can unblock pretty much anything you can think of, and it's fast as hell, so it won't slow down your connection by much when you're connected. You can find a download link for it in the description below, and you can use its 30-day refund to unblock websites for free for a whole month. It also has a full 7-day free trial on the mobile version. But If you want a completely free VPN, you can't do much better than Windscribe. Windscribe is one of the few truly secure free VPNs, and it doesn't really cost a penny. It also comes with unlimited bandwidth, so your speed isn't capped. However, you only get 10 gigabytes of data per month, but you can increase that to 15 gigabytes if you tweet about Windscribe. So earlier I said there is a right and wrong way to unblock a website. Well, here's the wrong way. You've probably heard of a proxy server, and at face value, it seems to do pretty much the same thing as a VPN. It reroutes your traffic through its own servers to make it look like you're in a different location. But there is one key difference, and that's encryption. A proxy does not encrypt your traffic. This means that even though the proxy server handles your traffic, everyone still can see it plainly, and this includes your school or your workplace. A proxy won't be able to unblock restricted websites the way a VPN can. And that's already it for today's video, guys. I really, really hope you found it helpful, and if you did, please give this video a like to help us with the YouTube algorithm. You can also comment below with any feedback you have for us or anything else you'd like to see us explain. Our team always goes through your comments, and we find your feedback very helpful. If you want to see more of our content, you can subscribe to our channel, and as always, hit the bell icon to get notified whenever we release a new video. And as always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye-bye.